When you come to the Caribbean, you only see the lovely, lovely side of the Caribbean where people come to relax. The beaches and the wonderful sunshine, fresh air, and the laid-back attitude of the people. But you don't see the other side, the destitute, the poor, those in hovels, those who are rejected by society. That part you don't see.
By all accounts, a paradise on earth. Nonetheless, Jamaica has a more sinister side. Kingston, Jamaica's capital, is regarded as one of the world's most dangerous cities. In a country of a mere 2,700,000 inhabitants, over 1,500 die each year, victims of narcotic gang warfare. Working in Jamaica, the missionaries of the poor endeavour to stand up against this appalling reality.
Jamaica is still a beautiful, beautiful country, but we do have the poverty and the crime. And this is why we are here, because we want to invite the government, invite those from the wealthier parts of Jamaica to try and come down and be present among the poor to provide a bonding, a bridge.
The history of the missionaries of the poor began in 1981. At that time, Richard Ho Lung, a Jesuit father, stunned by the great poverty and a lack of respect for human life, went after the call of his heart and decided to dedicate his life to helping Jamaica's poorest inhabitants. I am the truth,
the Lord of the heart. When we first began, we said, how are we going to do this? We have no house, we have no food, we don't know how to even take care of homeless people, whether they be children or adults. How are we going to go about it? Well, we just knew one thing, that Christ would not want his people to live in the streets and to die in the streets. Just that knowledge forced us to really say, okay, let us make an act of faith.
All right, ready? At the very beginning, Father Ho Lung and his companions had practically no backup. Today, over 26 years later, the missionaries of the poor carry aid to the sick, the homeless, the poor, prostitutes, single mothers, prisoners, irrespective of origin or belief. They receive no remuneration for their work.
The fundamental mission we have is to work among the least, those who really, unless you are there, they will die. We also try to assist the able-bodied poor. We use the term the destitute, those who are really abandoned, retarded, physically handicapped, mentally challenged, out on the street, homeless. For us, that's the fundamental focus of our lives.
Let us pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The missionaries presently own 5 homes, 2 for women, 2 for men, and 1 for children. They bring material and spiritual help. They often take on the role of stand-in families for people abandoned by their own families, as well as of parents of unwanted children. People dying from AIDS often choose to come to their homes.